In this video, I am going to discuss about financial instruments. Financial instruments are essentially contracts between parties that represent some form of value or ownership. These instruments can be traded, bought or sold, and are used to raise capital, manage risk or generate income. Some common examples of financial instruments. You just have to have the basic understanding of these instruments. Stocks. These are also called the shares. These represent ownership in a company and give the holder a share in its profits and losses. These are also called the equity finance. We discussed about different types of shares in details in a previous video. Bonds. These are debt securities issued by governments or corporations, which pay a fixed or variable interest rate over a set period of time. Mutual funds. These are investment vehicles that pool money from multiple investors to invest in a variety of assets, such as stocks, bonds, and other securities. Options. These are contracts that give the holder the right, but not the obligation, to buy or sell an underlying asset at a specified price and time. Futures. These are contracts to buy or sell an underlying asset at a specified price and time in the future. We discussed about options and futures in greater details under hedging. Derivatives. These are financial instruments that derive their value from an underlying asset, such as a stock, bond or commodity. Now let's discuss about stocks, shares, equity. All these terms are describing the same financial instrument. There are different ways companies issue shares. Initial public offering, IPO. The first time a company's shares are offered to the public. Private placement. Sale of shares to institutional investors such as private equity firms or venture capital firms. These will be issued to private institutional investors and individuals. Rights issue. Issuance of new shares to existing shareholders in proportion to their current ownership, which means individuals and institutions who have already bought the shares of the company, and they will be issued new shares under rights issue. Offer for sale. Selling shares through a bank to investors. Now let's discuss about how we can calculate the returns from the financial instruments. Market capitalization. Market capitalization, also known as market cap, is a measure of the total value of a company's outstanding shares of stock. Simply, this is the valuation of the company in the market. It is calculated by multiplying the total number of outstanding shares by the current market price of one share. This is the formula we can use to calculate the market capitalization of a company. Total number of shares in issue multiplied by current market price of a share. For an example, if a company has 10 million outstanding shares and the current market price of one share is $50, then the company's market capitalization would be 500 million. This is the formula. The total number of shares in issue is 10 million multiplied by the market value of one share, which is $50. This equals to 500 million. This is the market capitalization of the company, or the valuation of the company based on the current market price. Now let's discuss about what are dividends. A dividend is a payment made by a company to its shareholders as a distribution of a proportion of its profits. Typically, dividends are paid out in cash, although they can also be paid out in the form of additional shares or stock or other property. Dividends are typically paid on a regular basis, such as quarterly or annually, and are usually announced by the company's board of directors. The amount of the dividend is usually expressed as a fixed amount per share, although it can also be expressed as a percentage of the company's earnings or its stock price. Simply, the dividends is the form of return that the shareholders will receive. We discussed about ordinary shares. and also the preference shares. How these shareholders will receive their dividends? Decision to pay out the dividends for ordinary shareholders are at the company's board of directors' discretion, whereas preference shareholders will receive a fixed dividend. Now let's discuss about how we can calculate the returns to shareholders. Dividend yield. Yield term is used in finance for returns. So the dividend yield means dividend returns. Dividend yield is a financial ratio that measures the amount of dividends a company pays out to its shareholders relative to the current market price of its stock. It is expressed as a percentage. This is the formula we can use to calculate the dividend yield. Dividend paid per share divided by market price of a share. Very important thing to notice, when you use this formula, you need to make sure that the numerator and the denominator has the same unit. Which means if the question is given data as dollars and cents, these dollar values or cents values convert to one unit. Let's say they have given $3 value and 50 cent value. What you have to do is you have to either convert dollar value into cents or convert the cents value into dollars. So the numerator and the denominator will have a same unit. You have to do this when you use this equation. You can convert any currency into cents by multiplying by 100. So $3 equals to 300 cents. On the other hand, you can convert, let's say 50 cents into a dollar value by dividing this value by 100. So this equals to $0.5. Now let's do this example. A company pays an annual dividend of $2 per share and its current market price per share is $50. Then its dividend yield would be $2 divided by $50 and then multiplied by 100%. So the dividend yield or the dividend return equals to 4%. Let's say they have given the annual dividend in cents, let's say 60 cents. And now let's recalculate this example. So this will be 60 cents divided by 100. We converted this cent value into dollar value, then divide by the per share value. 0.6 divided by 50, then multiplied by 100, 1.2%. Let's do this example. Issued shares 10,000. This means there are 10,000 shares in issue. Current share price is $3. Dividend payment is $1 per share. Now let's calculate the net dividend yield. Don't worry about this net value, which will be the dividend equation as well. So the net dividend yield equals to dividend per share divided by market value of share multiplied by 100. So the dividend per share is $1. Market value of share is $3 multiplied by 100. So the answer will be 33.3%. Now let's talk about bonds or debentures. These are also a form of financial instruments. These can be also traded in an exchange. Bonds and debentures are types of financial instruments that companies and governments use to raise money from investors. A bond is a type of fixed income investment where an investor loans money to an entity, typically a government or a corporation, in exchange for periodic interest payments and the return of the initial investment, known as the principal, at a specified maturity date. A debenture is also a type of debt instrument that allows a company to borrow money from investors. Unlike a bond, a debenture is not secured by any specific asset, but instead relies on the issuer's creditworthiness. Debentures typically pay a fixed rate of interest to investors and have a specified maturity date, at which point the issuer must repay the principal. For BA1, you only have to have the basic understanding of bonds and debentures. You can use the bonds and debentures interchangeably. In the next levels, these will be discussed in greater detail. Now let's discuss how we can calculate the returns from bonds and debentures. Important thing to note that we are considering bonds and debentures as the same financial instrument. We are not considering the differences between bonds and debentures for these calculations. We can calculate the bill rate or the yield by using this formula, which is the bill rate or yield equals to bond value multiplied by the coupon rate. When it comes to bonds and debentures, the interest rate is also called the coupon rate. So the term coupon rate is used instead of interest rate. So when you come across a coupon rate, you have to have the understanding of they are discussing about a bond or a debenture. And then we can calculate the running yield, which equals to annual interest divided by the market value of a bond multiplied by the 100%. Here you have to calculate the annual interest. This is not the interest rate. You have to calculate the annual interest on the nominal value of the bond. For the denominator, you have to use the market value of the bond. Very important thing to remember, do not use the interest rate here. You have to calculate the annual interest based on the nominal value of the bond. Then we have the net dividend yield. We discussed this earlier under shares. Annual dividend divided by market value of bond multiplied by 100%. The only change here is we are now considering the value of bond. Now let's do this example. A bond has the following features: nominal value $1,000, coupon rate 3%. What this means? This is the interest rate. For the bonds. Now you know when you see a coupon rate, it is for bonds and debentures. Then the current market value is $1,100. Calculate the running yield on this bond. So the running yield equals to annual interest divided by the market value of bond multiplied by the 100%. See here, now we have to calculate the annual interest. This equals to nominal value of the bond multiplied by the coupon rate. So this equals to 1000 multiplied by, remember always we have to convert the percentage value into a decimal value, so 3 divided by 100. So this will be the annual interest, then divided by the market value of the bond. Market value is 1100, then multiplied by 100%. So the running yield is 2.73%. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.